Okay, we're gonna do a little video here, and we're gonna talk about some different canned corned beef here. This is Mario's brand, and this is a smaller can that you can buy at the dollar store. And it says product of Brazil, which is fairly common. Pretty much all the brands you find now are from Brazil, or quite a few of them. I know years ago there was a store brand in a local store here that was product of Brazil, but then I think it was around 2012 or something like that, they had that kind of that mad cow scare. So I think they banned all the, or suspended the importation of beef from Brazil. So then for a while it was product of Australia, which I think is Ox and Palm brand or something like this, because then there's a Palm brand from like New Zealand you can get. But then when they okayed the Brazilian stuff, then it went back to being product of Brazil. But this stuff was like eaten by like massive amounts, like during the wars, soldiers ate it. They shipped like boatloads of it to the Russians, I think, because they were having some major issues with food production. They much were having it before the war started, but the war just irritated it further. But like a lot of it's from Brazil now. It used to be like more of it, I guess, from like Uruguay. Sort of, yeah, I guess you can still see that on some brands, but I think some's from like Argentina as well. But anyway, so this stuff is from Brazil, but then the other day, or a while back, I noticed there's the bigger version of the same brand here. This is 198 grams, and this one's the 340 gram. It's more of the classic style can. They're both the same shape. They're kind of, you know, square, but they taper. You can like, stack easy and all this kind of stuff. This product of France, which was kind of weird. So maybe it's a tiny bit more trustworthy. I don't know. This one's good till 2022. But it's kind of weird that they glue the key on the top of it. Like a lot of the older ones, the key was on the bottom. It was like soldered or something to the can, and you broke it off and then put it on the little tab here. Most Brazilian ones you find now, the key is on the side and it's just on the tab. They fold the tab over to hold it on. But yeah, they had a lot of this like in the wars, and a lot of people store it for, you know, prepper kind of stuff because it lasts like a long time. This one's, as I said, like 2022. This one's 2023, so and it probably lasts longer than that. It's salted meat. You know, the taste of it might degrade after that, but I'm not really sure. A lot of it doesn't taste like the best anyway. But it's, I don't know, it's not something you want to eat all the time, I guess, but it's good with, you know, corned beef and hash, and you can make all kinds of different stuff. You can put it on sandwiches, but you can just eat it. It's already cooked and everything, so you can eat it right the way it is, but it's, you know, it's got lots of fat and salt and stuff in it, but I don't know, it is what it is. So, but it's just, I just found that kind of neat. There was a product of France, so that's that's probably, maybe it's horse meat, I don't know. I did see one thing online that mentioned that there was something that was being imported somewhere that they sort of discovered that some of it had like horse DNA in it or something like this, but I don't know how true that is. But the French do like their horse meat, but I guess, but, you know, I'm not really sure if it's a big deal. It's good enough for the German army and Russia, then. So anyway, so maybe we'll open this smaller can here, the Brazilian one. Let's see what it tastes like. We'll just slice it up and eat the way it is. A lot of times I'll put it on like bread or something, or I fried it up with potatoes. potatoes and stuff before, but so I got our open all here. Let's cut the label off because see it's all. Wound up in the thing. So. You know, I keep this sort of thing sort of centered on the key here because it gets off the edge and it doesn't work so well. I don't think it was working that well anyway. It's not really ripping the thing very well. And this has been cooled, so it's easier. I think, well, it's probably easier to get out of the can, but it's easier to slice it anyway. But, see, I told you how to do that. Now it's getting all screwed up. Alright. So that didn't work so well, did it? Let's see here. I'm just gonna get a pair of pliers, or should I just? There's no real way to open this easily, but all right, back. Okay, Leatherman to the rescue here. And I was gonna mention that. It's like, oh, these cans come with their own key. You don't have to worry about having a can opener. Thanks so much for that. That's the first time one of these is actually broken off on me. The way around. That's beautiful looking stuff, isn't it? Well, it's like these basically just beef salt and like sodium nitrate or something that makes it pink like this. Get a little bit of metal away here. Isn't that pretty? This is cut with a sharp knife, so I'm going to use the opal. Doesn't look terrible, I guess. Or does it? Yeah, it does. Got lots of lots of fat in it. Lots of like cartilage or something in there. Yeah, tastes alright. Kind of dry. I think the New Zealand one, I think it's like corned beef and it has like whipped juices or something, so it's, and it has a bit more like grain to it, so it doesn't, like this is more, a lot more chewed up and then put together kind of thing, but I don't know, it's edible I guess. Oh, most appetizing thing. Because it's sort of easier to eat when it's cold like this, when it's more like more congealed. As soon as this all melts, it just sort of gets more kind of gross, or grosser. Oh yeah, let's get on a piece of bread or something. There's a lot of worse things you're gonna eat, like the zombie apocalypse, I guess. Get some of this and some canned sardines, and you're good to go. There's like 120 calories and 8 grams of fat, so just times all that by 4. 330 milligrams of sodium. Some iron in it. Protein. Lots of protein and stuff. It's not the worst. I don't know. Seems alright. I have nothing really against the Brazilian stuff, but other than he didn't work that well, but I guess that's the shit happens, I guess. It's good to have a multi-tool around. Actually, I probably could open that with the Victorinox can opener, I think. Just so, like, it's a weird angled can, so I don't know if it... I'm sure you can go around. But this is a lot easier, because you open it this way, then it's a lot easier to get the meat out of it. Actually, the short cans are pretty decent. Like, these bigger ones, mine's it's a bit harder to get the... But you usually just squeeze the can a little bit, and it'll sort of fall out. Plus, it's, you know, the meat is kind of wedge-shaped, so it's... You know, it's like a 303 cartridge. It extracts easy because it has a lot of taper to it. So, anyway, I'll probably put this in a container and put it in the fridge because I don't want to eat like too much of this in one sitting. But get my daily intake of 7 days of sodium in one day. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and talk to you later.